Hey YouTube, this is Lucy from kbeautyhobby.com. Today's video is about my tips and tricks for fall and winter skincare. I think fall and winter are coming. It is the end of August as I'm filming this. I'll probably publish it in the first couple weeks of September. It's finally cooling off here in the Midwest. I am absolutely sick of having every single day be in the 90s. It is just incredibly hot. The little ground squirrels that live in my garden have been stealing tomatoes because they're so dehydrated. So I'm just ready for a nice cool front, and I'm missing sweater weather and warm drinks and fuzzy slippers and gloves and all of those things. So today I'm going to give you some tips and tricks on adjusting your skincare routine to really maximize it during the fall and winter. My first tip is just to be open-minded. Get ready to adjust your routine. You may or may not need to, but typically the same thing does not work all year round for most people. So just be flexible and listen to your skin, like I always say, and see what exactly it is asking for. Tip number two is to focus on things that are harder to address in the summer. For example, hyperpigmentation. You may not want to use any aggressive products in the summer because they will make your skin sensitive to light, photosensitive in other words, but in the fall and winter, it is more appropriate. I have some examples, but these are just examples, so you find whatever works for you. One example is this Make Prem Peel Me, and this is a sleeping mask that is exfoliating in nature. It is actually fairly gentle, and I have used it outside of fall and winter, but if you've never used an overnight peeling mask, you may want to wait until fall and winter to experiment with it. Another product is this DMCell AHA peeling lotion, and this one I've actually started trying in the summer because that's when I got it, but I did get some peeling from it, which makes sense. And AHA makes the skin photosensitive, not just when you're using it, but for a little while afterwards as well. So I actually decided to table this until fall, when I have a less chance of getting some sort of sun damage. In the last example here, I have a retinol product. This is a Dr. Different Vita A cream. And this is retinol with an A. But there's also retinol products, and if you've never used them, there's some adjustment period. Quarantine was a good time to start them because you could have some peeling and so forth. But if you didn't, fall and winter is a good time to start, again, for the same reason as the AHA photosensitivity. To go along with that photosensitivity is my next tip, and that is do not skip sunscreen. Just because it may look overcast, just because it is cold, doesn't mean that your skin is not taking a beating. Any sort of efforts that you're making to improve your skin, hyperpigmentation, anti-aging, anything, they're pretty much in vain if you're not protecting your skin from the sun. I have a whole video on sunscreens that you can watch on my channel, but in short, UVA rays especially are present all year long, and they go through windows unless those windows are specifically treated. So that is the part of a ray that actually really ages the skin. It hinders collagen production, can also increase your pore sizes. I'm definitely not a chemist, and you can find better worded resources on this if you're curious, but just in short, don't skip sunscreen because you would be doing your skin a disservice, even if it's winter. The next tip is to hydrate. Watch your moisture levels. That goes for both inside and outside, so definitely drink your water. You know probably all about that. I think just about any health expert talks about it. But from the outside perspective, watch the temperature of the showers that you take and the temperature of the water that you use to wash your hands. Especially right now, we're washing our hands probably more than ever. Warm and hot water feel really good, but they can strip the skin of moisture a lot more than lukewarm or cold water. So if you're taking a nice shower that is hot, maybe try to scale it back a little bit, especially if you're starting to develop dryness. And a great way to get some moisture into your skin is to use a humidifier, either a whole house one, like a central one, or just a small, inexpensive Amazon one or wherever you can find it, just a local one. I have one that is completely silent, and I really enjoy that. Or I should say it's almost completely silent. It doesn't bother me. So I will put a link in the description box, but any kind of humidifier that works for you is fine. If you can use it during the day, even better, but I personally cannot. I don't think that would be a good thing to set in my office next to all the equipment that I have. So I just stick to using it at night, and it makes a huge difference for my skin and even for my breathing. I've had way fewer issues with upper respiratory type of things using a humidifier. The next tip is to properly lock in all of that hydration. A good way to get some moisture, some hydration into your skin are toners and essences. If you're confused about the difference, or if you don't know what a typical Korean skincare routine looks like, I do have a video with the whole routine explained step by step. But putting all of that lovely moisture in doesn't really work if you don't properly lock it in. So consider having a really great moisturizer. You may have to go a little bit more robust. If you're somebody like me, I have combination skin. In the summer, I barely use a moisturizer in the mornings. Usually just my SPF is enough. But in the winter, I typically go for a moisturizer and then the SPF just to protect the skin from the elements and really try to avoid all the damage, especially if it gets windy or really cold. Another thing you can do is get a great sleeping mask. The one I'm really enjoying is this Claire's Freshly Juiced Vitamin E mask. Of course, my camera is going to make it super, super white. I'm sorry, there. Maybe you can see it better this way. It's a very nourishing mask, and there are other ones out there, but just find something that is probably a little bit more nourishing and a little bit richer than what you would typically use in the summer. Even if you have oilier combination skin, just play around. Don't be afraid of moisturizers. For a very long time, I didn't think I needed any creams because my skin is a bit on the oily side, but it's actually made a huge difference because when my skin is dehydrated, it overcompensates by producing even more oil. So providing it with enough hydration and enough moisture helps with that tremendously. Last tip is to protect your skin from the elements as much as possible. So scarves, gloves, hats, lip balms, sunscreen, moisturizers, all of those things. The more you can cover, the better. I typically have a scarf that goes all the way to my eyes pretty much. Of course, this year I'm probably going to be wearing a mask anyway going into the building because that's required at my job. So do your best to cover as much as possible, and obviously if you can, stay out of the cold and stay out of the wind. For the lips, a simple lip balm is just fine, whatever works for you, or even an overnight sleeping mask like Laneige or the J. Estina. They don't have to be just used as a sleeping mask. They actually make a fantastic sort of a lip gloss looking finish for the day. I often use those during the day. But another thing I've been using are these LA or Lamuse, these lip balms. They're tinted. I am currently wearing the one in the color Bud. I really like it. This came to me in a PR box, and I've posted about them on my Instagram, and I've done swatches in the unboxing video for the August Sophie's box if you want to just see it more. But basically these are like an more intense color lip balms than just a typical tinted lip balm, but they're very, very nourishing, and they look like this. Very creamy. I just have one coat on. You can make the color pretty intense. Like, it can actually look like lipstick if you do a couple coats, but I just do one because I like the more subtle look. But something like that will work too. These are not transfer proof. They will absolutely stain your masks, although that washes out pretty easily for me. And so it's just a tinted lip balm, but I really like these. These are probably one of the better tinted lip balms that I've ever tried. So just find something that works for you. So to review, be ready to adjust your routine, protect your skin, hydrate, and then if you have anything that couldn't be addressed in the summer, like hyperpigmentation, for example, you can go ahead and really zero in on that during the fall and winter when the sun is not so bad. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found it useful. If you have your own tips and tricks, please leave me a comment. I would love to hear from you because I'm always learning, and it's just amazing how much knowledge there is and how much awesome information people can share if they're willing. I hope you're having a lovely week. You can find me on my blog, kbeautyhobbit.com, on Instagram at kbeautyhobbit, and in my Facebook group, Korean Beauty Fanatics. I will see you in my next video, and until then, please have a lovely, lovely time, and always remember to listen to your skin. Thank you so much.